Hello, I'm Vladislavos, the product owner for Teltonika's professional devices category. In today's video, we will demonstrate how to install FMC650 tracker using a plug-and-play solution with FMS cable, and how easy it is to integrate this device into your fleet. With FMC650, you can receive FMS and tachograph data, download DDD files, and monitor driver behavior using FMS Echo Driving solution. Before we install the device, let's configure it for proper use case.
Let's set up the FMC650. Out of the box, it comes with default factory settings, so you will need to adjust them to match your needs. You can do this easily using the Teltonika configurator. Before beginning the configuration, please ensure the device is ready and the SIM card is properly installed. Without it, the tracker will not transmit data. First, download the configurator from the Teltonika Wiki. Go to the configurator version page, select FMC650 and click download. Once the file is downloaded, extract it and open the program. You can change the language by clicking the gear icon on the bottom right corner. Next, connect the tracker to your PC and select it in the configurator. Once connected, you'll see a status window with different tabs for GNSS, GSM, I/O, maintenance, and more. You can customize the settings and save your changes using the Save to Device button. Make sure to check the GPRS section to set up server and GPRS settings, and the data acquisition section to configure how data is collected. FMS connector uses a single CAN connection for FMS and tachograph data. Configure the device to read both by setting DDD download source and FMS data source to CAN1. For more details, visit our wiki page. Now, let's move on to installing the device in the truck with the FMS cable. To install the tracker, you will need to follow these steps. Start by removing the panel inside the vehicle to access the FMS plug location. Since this is a Mercedes truck, it is located next to the tachograph. Use the Teltonika plug-and-play FMS connector to connect the FMC650 device. Simply plug it to the vehicle's FMS port and connect the 20-pin connector to the tracker. The FMS connector includes a power supply, an ignition wire, CAN wires for vehicle's FMS data and tachograph digital file data, as well as K-line signal wire for tachograph live data. Please note that the K-line wire may not be available depending on the vehicle's make and model. In such case, we recommend routing the K-line signal wire to the tachograph's D connector. Before wiring, let's double check if GNSS and GSM antennas are working. Connect them to the FMC650. The GNSS and status LEDs should blink every second, confirming signal reception and normal function. Turn on the vehicle and check that the FMC650 is receiving the data from the FMS connection and transmitting it correctly. You can do that by sending tachocheck SMS command or by checking the configurator or server data. After these steps, disconnect the antennas and route the cables through the panel openings. Place antennas under the dashboard and A pillar. Close everything up. And connect them back to the tracker. Mount the device by securely attaching it to the chassis of the truck. Once everything is connected, carefully mount back the panel, ensuring that no cables are pinched or exposed.
You now have a clear understanding of how FMC650 is installed and the features it offers. As you can see, the process is straightforward. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out to our sales team, our IoT support engineers, or leave a comment below this video. Thanks for watching, and we're looking forward to seeing you in our next videos.